This truly was a historic and a monumental project. When we approached this building as a potential site, it clearly was a dusty old warehouse. We were able to, with the assistance of multiple teams across the globe, convert what was that simple warehouse into a high-class, fully functioning medical device manufacturing facility, all within the space of 4 weeks from initial contact with GM.
When I first heard about the timeline and the request and the ask, I thought that it was a bit insane. You know, this is something that could potentially take years to do in normal times. Looking at the resources we had at hand, and as I worked with the team more and more, I realized this is something that we were gonna do.
There are three things that really it takes for something like this to happen. First and foremost, you need a coordinated team of talented, highly motivated individuals with a breadth of skill set as well as expertise. Number two, you need a facility. And in this case, we had a blank canvas. And number three, you really need the trust and the support from the leadership of the companies that are involved to empower the team to just go make it happen. And we had all three of those, and we made it happen.
Making something like this happen was quite an endeavor. We have logistics people from GM, conference calls at the wee hours of the morning in Reno, Nevada to be communicating with them at the beginning of their day. Communications with folks in Switzerland without any of the Swiss manufacturing team being here. It was quite an accomplishment to be involved with. Just make all these pieces of the puzzle fit together.
We had to translate a lot of documentation. We had to validate a lot of what had been established in Switzerland. And a lot of that was tribal knowledge. And we had to overcome that and turn that into a process that was repeatable, that was quality.
We had basically a year's worth of work to do in a matter of weeks, coming together with so many people and making sure that everybody was working on their tasks and people weren't duplicating efforts because every minute mattered. You know, wasting 1 hour was wasting hundreds of hours.
We completely took out of our vocabulary, why can't? Why can't this happen? Why can't that happen? Instead, we just focused on what do we need to do to make it happen? And the results speak for themselves. We did it. We accomplished our goal.
Coronavirus restrictions did have some effect on our ability to get this project up and running. There was a lot of challenges from sort of, I would say, the logistics side of things. Fewer flights crossing the oceans meant fewer opportunities for us to import much needed components to build the ventilators.
I think the partnership of General Motors in Hamilton was a perfect match. We have Hamilton, who brought in their very technologically advanced ventilator. We have General Motors, who brought in our experience with launching product at high volumes. And we have executed something that would have been impossible otherwise.
Everybody was dedicated. Everybody was working around the clock. Nobody wanted to quit. Nobody said a negative word about the project.
Watching that first unit come off the production line at about 10 o'clock at night on a Saturday was pretty cool. A lot of hard work.
I was right there with the very first one that came off the line. We had just finished putting the handle on. We turned the ventilator around and put the battery in, and it lit up. And then to see it turn on was just an amazing feeling.
That it was a big moment going into this. I thought this could potentially be one of the biggest things I ever do in my career. And seeing that come to fruition when that first ventilator turned on, it was very, very fulfilling and very exciting.
You know, the short days have been maybe 12 hours, but pulling some double shift days, you get to know people and get a good friendship.
We'd eat breakfast, lunch, and dinner with them. We were on the phone with them all day long. We were working hand in hand to make sure that we could get this project accomplished. And so they became a second family over the course of this project. It's great.
When the U.S. government put it upon industry to figure out how to make this project work, how to bring life-saving devices to the market, without the assistance of our teammates in Switzerland, without the assistance of General Motors and the support of Hamilton Company, there's no way that this project takes flight. Truly, it's been inspiring to see how all these entities, all these organizations could come together with one mission in mind, one goal in mind, and actually witness that happen and to be a part of making that happen.
These are kind of tumultuous times that we're in. It's exciting to be able to contribute to something that I feel is extremely important right now, and I'm just hopeful that it makes an impact in the world.
Something I'll never forget.